All right, come on, Scott, let's go, man. We got 20 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, baby, let's go. Name something about their wedding a bride cares more about than the groom does.
Food.
At what age does a man say he's ready to settle down?
25.
Name something that's plump and red.
Beach.
Name the thing in your bathroom you clean the most often.
Bathtub.
Fill in the blank. Picnic blank.
Blanket.
All right, here we go. Name something about their wedding a bride cares more about than the groom does. You said more about the food, survey said. At what age does a man say he's ready to settle down? You said 25, survey said. Name something that's plump and red. You said peach, survey said. Oh. Name the thing in your bathroom you clean the most often. You said bathtub, survey said. Fill in the blank, picnic blank. You said picnic blanket, survey said. All right, we'll be okay. We'll be okay. Come on, Annie. Well, Annie, you need 146.
You can do it.
Scott got 54. We can still win this money. This is doable.
Okay.
Okay, good.
Okay, okay.
All right, let's remind everybody of Scott's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Name something about their wedding a bride cares more about than the groom does.
The way they look.
At what age does a man say he's ready to settle down?
30.
Name something that's plump and red.
Tomato.
Name the thing in your bathroom you clean the most often.
Toilet.
Fill in the blank, picnic blank.
Blanket.
Try again.
Basket.
Name something about their wedding a bride cares more about than the groom does. You said the way they look. Survey said. Dress and clothes was the number one answer. At what age does a man say he's ready to settle down? You said 30. Survey said. Was the number one answer.
Good job, girl.
Name something that's plump and red. You said tomato. Survey said. Tomato was the number one answer. Name the thing in your bathroom you clean the most often. You said toilet. Survey said. Was the number one answer. Fill in the blank, picnic blank, you said. Picnic basket, survey said. Wow. I've never seen anybody do that before. Welcome back to The Feud, everybody. The Gonzalez family won the game. And now it's time to play. All right, here we go. Matthew Myers off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Maya together come up with 200 points. Tell everybody what you're gonna win.
$20,000!
All right, Matthew. Ready?
Ready, sir.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, man, let's win some money. We asked 100 married women, instead of bringing you flowers, Name something you'd rather have your husband do for you.
Clean.
Name an article of clothing that you don't bother with on a hot day.
Shirt.
Name an animal that makes a lot of noise.
Dog.
What time is the crack of dawn?
5 o'clock.
Name one word a preacher might use many times during his sermon.
Amen.
We ask 100 married women, instead of bringing you flowers, name something you'd rather have your husband do for you. You said, clean. Yes. Survey said. Name an article of clothing you don't bother with on a hot day. You said, you don't even wear no shirt. You're just sexy with it, Matthew. Survey said. Name an animal that makes a lot of noise. You said, dog. Survey said. What time is the crack of dawn? You said, 5 a.m. Survey said. Name one word a preacher might use many times during his sermon. You said, amen. Amen. Survey said. Maya, how you feeling?
I'm excited. How about you?
Hey, I'm super excited. You're wonderful.
I'm excited.
You're like, oh, God. Let me ask you something.
Yes.
Your relationship to Matthew is what?
He's my uncle.
He's your uncle?
Yes.
How many points do you think Uncle Matthew?
At least 100 plus. I would expect at least that much of
At least 100. Well, okay, he got more than 100.
Thank God, I would hope so. So
give me just one guess.
142.
Wow. He got 176.
I was joking.
You need 24 points to win $20,000. You ready?
Yes.
All right, let's remind everybody of Matthew's answers. 25 seconds on the clock. We asked 100 married women, instead of bringing you flowers, name something you'd rather have your husband do for you.
The dishes.
Try again.
Laundry.
Try again.
Bring.
Name an article of clothing that you don't bother with on a hot day.
Bra.
Name an animal that makes a lot of noise.
Elephant.
What time is the crack of dawn?
8 a.m.
Name a word one preacher might use many times in his sermon.
Amen.
Try again.
Praise the Lord.
Give me a rut. Okay, let me read this. Just let me, because I stumble. Instead of bringing you flowers, name something you'd rather have your husband do for you.
Bring chocolates. There you go.
All right, let's go.
You got this.
We need 24 points. You asked 100 married women, instead of bringing you flowers, name something you'd rather have your husband do for you. You said, bring me chocolates. Survey said.
All right.
Clean the house and laundry was the number one answer. That's why we kept saying, try again. Name an article of clothing that you don't bother with on a hot day. You said, a bra. Survey said. Yeah! All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 men, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you like to talk about feelings?
1.
Tell me the month you start saving money for Christmas.
November.
Name something a dog sees that gets it all excited.
His owner.
Name an occupation for a man who's good with his hands.
Construction worker.
Give me a word that rhymes with flower.
Wow. Mauer. I found it.
We asked 100 men, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you like to talk about feelings? You said, about a 1. Survey said, me the month you start saving for Christmas. You said, November, you're buying one gift. Survey said. Name something the dog sees and gets it all excited. You said, their owner. Survey said. Name an occupation for a man who's good with his hands. You said, construction worker. Survey said. Give me a word that rhymes with flower. You said, mower.
It rhymes.
Survey said. That's okay, we're going to run. All right, Tony. Brian got 89.
Okay.
We need 111.
Okay.
We got a shot at this money, buddy.
All right, pal.
All right, let's remind everybody of Breanne's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, Tony. We asked 100 men, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you like to talk about feelings?
5.
Tell me the month you start saving money for Christmas.
October.
Name something a dog sees that gets it all excited.
Bone.
Name an occupation for a man who's good with his hands.
Construction.
Try again.
Carpenter.
Give me a word that...
auto mechanic.
Give me a word that rhymes with flower.
Power.
All right, let's go. We ask 100 men, scale of 1 to 10, how much you like to talk about feelings. You said... about a 5. Survey said... 1. 1 was the number one answer. Tell me the month you start saving money for Christmas. You said, around October. Survey said, January was the number one answer. Name something the dog sees that gets it all excited. You said, a bone. Survey said, another dog and food was tied for the top answer. Name an occupation for a man who's good with his hands. You said, auto mechanic. Survey said, number one answer, construction worker. We need 45 points. Give me a word that rhymes with flower. You said, power. Survey said, to the feud, everybody. The Cook family won the game. And now it's time to play...
Fast Money!
You ready?
Yeah.
20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 married women, on a scale of 1 to 10, how calm do you think your husband would be during a real emergency?
2.
Name something you might write a review of.
Food.
Restaurant. Name a state that could be its own country.
Alaska.
Name an animal that catches its food with its tongue.
Dog.
Name the biggest nut.
Hazelnut.
All right, here we go. We asked 100 married women on a scale of 1 to 10, how calm do you think your husband would be during a real emergency? You said 2. Survey said... Name something you might write a review of. You said... food. Survey said... Name a state that could be its own country. You said... Alaska, way up there. Survey said... Name an animal that catches its food with its tongue. You said... dog. Survey said... Name the biggest nut. You said hazelnut. Survey said. I have no idea. All right, let's go. How you doing
today?
Bad
news, huh?
I have bad news? No, not really.
Oh, okay.
Let me just say this. Okay. There's a chance you could win $20,000. If you focus, I got a lot of big answers on this card.
Okay.
If you give them to me, we dancing.
Great. All right,
okay?
I got it. Yep.
You ready?
Ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of Jewel's answer. 25 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 married women, on a scale of 1 to 10, how calm do you think your husband would be during a real emergency?
1.
Name something you might write a review of.
A restaurant.
Try again.
A company.
Name a state that could be its own country.
California.
Name an animal that catches its food with its tongue.
Frog.
Name the biggest nut.
A macadamia nut.
All right, let's see.
Okay.
Sorry.
That's why we just...
A dog.
It's okay, you can do it. We in a ball game. Let's see what we got. We asked 100 married women on a scale of 1 to 10. How calm do you think your husband would be during a real emergency? You said 1, even less than 2.
It's true.
It's true? Wow. Survey said, and she married him. Okay. 10 was the number one answer.
They're lying. They're...
Mm.
Yeah.
Name something you might write a review of. You said... Company, survey said... Aww. Movie was the number one answer. Name a state that could be its own country. You said... California, survey said... Texas was the number one answer. Name an animal that catches its food with its tongue. You said... Frog. Survey said... Frog was the number one answer. Name the biggest nut. You said... The macadamia nut. Survey said... Walnut. Walnut was number one. Won the game. And now it's time to play.
Yes, money!
All right, now, Connie is off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Connie together come up with 200 points. Look right there. Tell everybody what you're gonna win.
$20,000!
All right, you ready?
Ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. When it comes to clothing, every woman searches for the perfect what?
Dress.
At what age do boys stop thinking girls are gross?
13.
Tell me a flower you might see in a corsage.
Pass.
When you get too hot, sweat runs down your what?
Face.
Name something you insure.
Pass.
Tell me a flower you might see in a corsage.
Rose.
Tell me something you insure.
Your car.
Wow. All right, here we go. When it comes to clothing, every woman searches for the perfect what? You said... Perfect dress. Survey said... At what age do boys stop thinking girls are gross? You said... 13. Survey said... Tell me a flower you might see in a corsage. You said... Rose. Survey said... When you get too hot, sweat runs down your what? You said... Face. Survey said... Name something you insure. You said... A car. Survey said... Well, Connie, what needed to happen just happened. We got a big number out here.
Okay.
I'm happy for about that. How many points you think she got?
130?
Nah, we need a little bit more than that. She got 175.
Good job, cousin!
Connie, we need 25 points.
Yes, sir.
You got this.
I need you to focus.
Yes, sir.
Don't take it for granted.
Yes.
You ready?
Yes, sir.
Let's remind everybody of Arnie's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. When it comes to clothing, every woman searches for the perfect what?
Purse.
At what age do boys stop thinking girls are gross?
30.
Tell me a flower you might see in a corsage.
A rose.
Try again.
An orchid.
When you get too hot, sweat runs down your what?
Back.
Name something you insure.
Car.
Try again.
House.
Come on. Let's go, Connie.
Ani, oh, God.
All right, here we go. When it comes to clothing, every woman searches for the perfect what? You said perfect purse. Survey said?
No, it's okay.
Bra. Bra was the number one answer. I have no idea. At what age do boys stop thinking girls are gross? You said. Survey said.
Yeah.
Number one answer was 12. Tell me a flower you might see in a corsage. You said the very expensive orchid.
Yeah.
Survey said.
All right.
Rose was the number one answer. When you get too hot, sweat runs down your what? You said your back. Survey said. Welcome back to The Feud, everybody. Wilson family won the game. And now it's time to play...
Money!
All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 married men to fill in the blank. You should never compare your wife to another woman by saying, why don't you blank like her?
Why don't you cook like her?
Name something a dog might do twice as much as you do.
Pee.
Name someone who could ruin a wedding if they showed up drunk.
The ex.
How long does a workout last?
An hour.
Name a farm animal with a big appetite.
A horse.
Good job, Captain. Good job, Captain. Good job, Captain. Did you agree?
Yes.
All right, let's see how we did. We ask 100 married men, fill in the blank. You should never compare your wife to another woman by saying, why don't you blank like her? You said... Cook, survey said. Yeah. Name something a dog might do twice as much as you do. You said. P, survey said. Name someone who could ruin a wedding if they showed up drunk. You said. The ex, survey said. How long does a workout last? You said. About an hour, survey said. Name a farm animal with a big appetite. You said. Eat like a horse, survey said. Well, Ed, got pretty good news for you. Kathy got 134 points.
Really good.
You need 66 to win. Come on, let's focus, let's win some money. Is she ready?
Ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of Kathy's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 married men to fill in the blank. You should never compare your wife to another woman by saying, why don't you blank like her?
Have sex.
Name something a dog might do twice as much as you do.
Poop.
Try again.
Walk.
Name someone who could ruin a wedding if they showed up drunk.
Your uncle.
How long does a workout last?
An hour.
Try again.
Half an hour.
Name a farm animal with a big appetite.
Pig.
Good job.
We need 66 points for 20,000. We ask 100 married men, fill in the blank. You should never compare your wife to another woman by saying, why don't you blank like her? And you said, oh my God. Wow. Woo. That's about the worst thing you could say. Survey said. Number one answer was, why don't you look like her? Name something a dog might do twice as much as you do. You said, walk. Survey said. Pee and poop was the number one answer. Name someone who could ruin a wedding if they showed up drunk. You said, that world famous drunk uncle we all have. Survey said. The groom was number one. We need 50 points, need a couple of big ones. How long does a workout last? You said, about half an hour. Survey said. Ooh. 1 hour was the number one answer. We need 7 points. Name a farm animal with a big appetite. You said, pig. Survey said. Pig was the number one answer. Welcome back to the feud, everybody. Orange family won the game. Play!
Yes,
all right, you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. The bad news is you sprained your ankle. But the good news is you're in bed eating what dessert?
Pie.
Tell me the number of months it takes to plan a wedding.
12.
Fill in the blank. Turtle blank.
Say that again.
Fill in the blank. Turtle blank.
Turtle pie.
Give me a four-letter word that rhymes with blast.
Past.
Name something in life you can only do once.
Go ahead. Get married. Oh, well.
Here we go. Bad news is you sprained your ankle. Good news is you're in bed eating what dessert? You said? Ha. Survey said? Tell me the number of months it takes to plan a wedding. You said? 12. Survey said?
Yeah!
Fill in the blank. Turtle blank. You said? Turtle pie. Survey says?
All right!
Somebody!
Give me a four-letter word that rhymes with blast. You said? Pass. Survey said?
Please.
Yeah!
Name something in life you can only do once. You said, ha, get married. What?
That's good. That's good.
Survey said. All right, Seth, we got a little work to do. Radine got 68.
Okay.
But I'm gonna tell you something. You can still win this money.
All right.
Need 132 points.
Let's go for it.
Seth, you're a good player. You ready?
Okay.
All right, let's remind everybody of Radine's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. The bad news is you sprained your ankle. But the good news is you're in bed eating what dessert?
Ice cream.
Tell me the number of months it takes to plan a wedding.
9.
Fill in the blank. Turtle blank.
Turtleneck.
Give me a four-letter word that rhymes with blast.
Fast.
Name something in life you can only do once.
Get married.
Try again.
Die.
We need 132 points. The bad news, you sprained your ankle. The good news is you're in bed eating what dessert? You said my favorite, ice cream. Come Survey on, says.
Let's go.
Yeah!
Ice cream was the number one answer.
Yeah.
Good job, son.
Tell me the number of months it takes to plan a wedding. You said 9 months. Good. Survey said?
Okay.
12. 12 months was the number one answer. We still need a big one. 76 points. Okay. Fill in the blank. Turtle blank. You said?
Yep.
Turtleneck.
Yep.
Survey said, oh, I like that answer. I liked it a lot.
Wow.
I like that one a lot.
That's okay.
That's okay.
Turtle Dove was the number one answer. We need two big ones, man. We 73 points away. Give me a four-letter word that rhymes with blast. You said fast. Survey said, fast was the number one answer.
Come on.
Okay.
39 points away from the money. Name something in life you can only do once. You said, die. Survey said. Won the game. And now it's time to play.
Money.
All right, now, Moni, Ross is off stage. I'm going to ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Ross together come up with 200 points. Look right there. Tell everybody what you're going to win.
$20,000!
All right, you ready?
I am.
20 seconds on the clock, please.
Okay.
Name an occupation that you think deserves to make as much as a professional athlete.
Teachers.
Fill in the blank. Slap blank.
Pass.
Name something you take to bed with you.
A pillow.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a do-gooder are you?
80%.
Name an animal that would probably find you very tasty.
Alligator.
Slap blank.
Slap and shake.
Let's go.
Good job.
Good job.
Name an occupation you think deserves to make as much as a professional athlete. You said a teacher. You doggone right about that. Survey said.
Yeah.
Fill in the blank. Slap blank. You said slap and shake. Survey said. Okay. Name something you take to bed with you. You said pillow. Survey said. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a do-gooder are you? You said 80%. Survey said.
Wow.
Name an animal that would probably find you very tasty. You said alligator. Survey said.
Aww.
Okay, we are. Now, Ross, we got to put in some work, man. You're a financial literacy coach. You're going to do just fine at this. So financially, let me just put it to you this way. You're going to have to produce about 75% of the points.
It's okay.
Okay.
150. We can do that.
See that? See how smart he is? What's even more surprising is I was even close to the damn percentage. He said 150. I went, oh, hell. Yeah, you heard him. 150. Yeah. Go ahead, Steve. Yeah, man, you need 156 to win. All right. Come on, Ross. Let's remind everybody of Moni's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Name an occupation that you think deserves to make as much as a professional athlete.
Teacher.
Try again.
Doctor.
Fill in the blank. Slap blank.
Slap. I'm pass.
Name something you take to bed with you.
Pass.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a do-gooder are you?
7.
Name an animal that will probably find you tasty.
Bear.
Slap blank.
Slap back.
Something you take to bed with you.
Phone.
Name an occupation that you think deserves to make as much as a professional athlete. You said, doctor, survey said. Teacher. Teacher was the number one answer. Fill in the blank, slap blank. You said, slap back. Survey said, slap happy, happy. Name something you take to bed with you. You said, your phone. Survey said. A book or magazine was number one.
Okay. That's different.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a do-gooder are you? You said 7. Survey said. Number one answer was 8. 8. Name an animal that would probably find you very tasty. You said a bear. Survey said. Lion. Lion was the number one answer. Welcome back to The Feud, everybody. The Wallowick family won the game. And now it's time to play...
Fast Money!
All right now, Barbara. Carol is off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Carol together come over 200 points. Look right there, tell them what you're gonna win.
$20,000!
You ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 men, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a laid-back dude are you?
8.
Name something people use to make a wish.
One of those blowy things.
Name someone you sometimes have to make a deal with.
Your spouse.
Name something that might be blowing in the wind.
Leaves.
Name an animal that's known to be a great hunter.
A dog.
It's okay. We're doing okay. We ask 100 men, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a laid-back dude are you? You said... 8. Survey said...
Yes! Woo!
Name something people use to make a wish. You said... That little thing that you do that thing...
You pull out of the grass and you blow on them, their little white thingies.
Oh, the little dandelion.
Something like that.
It's the little thing with the... Okay. The little... Okay. You said... Dandelion, wishy thing. That's good. Survey said...
1.
All right.
Name someone you sometimes have to make a deal with. You said... Smile. Survey said...
Yes.
Name something that might be blowing in the wind. You said... Leave. Survey said...
1. Nice.
Name an animal that's known to be a great hunter. You said, yo, dog. Survey said.
All right.
All right, we're good. What's going on, Snow?
You can do it, Mom. You can do it.
now, Carol, Barbara got 86. You need 114.
Okay.
This is very doable. This is very, very doable.
All right.
I got big answers on this card. You give them to me, we're going to still win 20,000,
yes,
okay?
Will.
All we got to do is focus, okay?
Yep.
All right, this is how we're going to do it. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're going to hear this sound. I'm going to say try again. You give me another answer. It's going to be a little bit tougher this time. So we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yes.
All right, let's remind everybody of Barbara's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. We ask 100 men, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a laid-back dude are you?
8.
Try again.
7.
Name something people use to make a wish.
Pass.
Name someone you sometimes have to make a deal with.
Car salesman.
Name something that might be blowing in the wind.
A leaf.
Try again.
Snow.
Name an animal that's known to be a great hunter.
A deer.
Name someone people use to make a wish. Name something people use to make a wish.
The four-leaf clover.
Okay. All right, let's go. We ask 100 men, scale of 1 to 10, how much of a laid-back dude are you? You said 7. Survey said 8. 8 was the number one answer. Name something people use to make a wish. You said the four-leaf clover. Survey said star. Star was number one. Name someone you sometimes have to make a deal with. You said car salesman. Survey said kids. Kids are the number one answer. Name something you might, something that might be blowing in the wind. You said snow. Survey said leaves. Leaves were number one. Name an animal that's known to be a great hunter.
I said a deer.
You said those vicious deer.
Oh, my gosh.
Survey said lion. Lion. Welcome back to The Feud, everybody. The Daniel family won the game. And now it's time to play...
Fancy!
All right, now Brittany Cedric is off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Cedric together come up with 200 points. Tell them what you're gonna win.
$20,000!
All right, you ready?
Yes, sir.
20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 single women, what might a friend buy you that tells you he wants more than friendship?
Lingerie.
At a restaurant, name a side dish you can order with your eggs.
Bacon.
Tell me the longest you've ever gone without changing your underwear.
A day.
Name something you can train a seal to do.
Make noises.
Name someone who blows a whistle.
A referee.
Okay, Brittany, we ask 100 single women, what might a friend buy you that tells you he wants more than friendship? You said lingerie. Survey said. At a restaurant, name a side dish you can order with your eggs. You said some bacon. Survey said. Tell me the longest you've ever gone without changing your underwear. You said a day. Survey said. Name something you can train a seal to do. You said make noise. Survey said. Name someone who blows a whistle. You said referee. Survey said. Pretty good, man. Brittany got 134 points. Cedric, we need 66 to win. 66 in the second position is still tough. We got focus, man, okay?
Gotcha.
All right, come on now. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time. I'm gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Ready.
All right, let's remind everybody Brittany's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, say it. We asked 100 single women, what might a friend buy you that tells you he wants more than friendship?
Roses.
At a restaurant, name a side dish you can order with your eggs.
Pass.
Tell me the longest you've ever gone without changing your underwear.
2 days.
Name something you can train a seal to do.
Clap.
Name someone who blows a whistle.
A referee.
Try again.
Police officer.
Give me a side dish you can order with your eggs.
Bacon.
Try again.
Sausage.
Okay, sausage. We need 66 points. We ask 100 single women, what might a friend buy you? Tells you he wants more than friendship. You said, come in the door with some roses.
Yes, sir.
Survey said. Jewelry and ring was number one. 46 points away. At a restaurant, name a side dish you can order with your eggs. You said, give me some sausage. Survey said. Hash browns was the number one answer. We need 43 points. Tell me the longest you've ever gone without changing your underwear. You said, without hesitation, 2 days. We men, we know that's true. Survey said. One day was the number one answer. We 10 points away. Name something you could train a seal to do. You said, clap. Survey said,